Okay, rest in peace, Colin Powell. Very sad. He was a very influential figure throughout my life because, you know, I grew up at the time of the first Gulf War. He was Secretary of State, George H.W., you know, the whole thing, right? So we don't need to rehash all that. But what we do need to talk about is how a lot of people in the sort of anti-vaccine side of the discussion are using his death because he contracted COVID as evidence that the vaccines don't work. So he was apparently fully vaccinated. He and his wife both contracted COVID. His wife got monoclonal antibodies, got better. He did not. Now, so what's going on? Well, it turns out it's important to know that he had multiple myeloma, which is a blood cancer off immune cells. So he was immunocompromised on a couple levels. He was 84, which puts him in that category of immune compromise. You just don't have a very robust immune system at that age. So even if you're vaccinated, he would be exactly the candidate who would benefit from a booster because that age group doesn't generate as much immune response in response to the first two shots. Now, the rest of the population, you know, 65 and under who are doing okay, don't have immune compromise, they're probably fine without boosters, right? Which we've done shows on. But Colin Powell was in the advanced age group, probably would have benefited from a booster and was, I think, scheduled to get one. So the fact that he got an infection, which they call a breakthrough, it's like, no, it's the vaccine is not perfect, right? So you add to that the fact that he had multiple myeloma, which, by the way, is an incredibly dangerous risk factor for having complications from COVID, regardless of vaccination. But then vaccination itself in the setting of immune compromise means the vaccine is going to be less effective because your immune system is less effective. You know, one thing I really like to impress on people is that, you know, people are all think there's this dichotomy between doing well naturally, whether it's natural infection, whether it's natural diet, whether it's, you know, avoiding medical interventions, things like that, which, by the way, I'm for, versus the artificial stuff, you know, medicines, vaccines, all of this. But you got to understand with vaccines, what you're doing is you're taking something very natural and robust and holistic, which is the human immune system, and you're teaching it to do its thing for a particular disease agent, in this case, coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2. And so you, through vaccination, are actually employing a natural process, which is your immune system. If that natural process is impaired through cancer, which is what Colin Powell had, and age, which he was 84, it's going to make it much harder for this to work. Now, so I don't think this says anything about, you know, vaccines as a tool against this disease. What it does say is, yes, elders probably should get a booster. People with immune compromise like Colin Powell should have gotten a booster. That's the population you boost, not everybody else, right? Not just the worried well necessarily. And the second thing about it is that the population spread of coronavirus actually becomes important for people who are vulnerable. So people like Colin Powell, if the entire community was vaccinated at a very high rate, the amount of circulating coronavirus would be less because it replicates less. There's, you know, 5 to 10-fold less infection. And if you do get infected and you have big time symptoms, yeah, you're going to transmit, but your chances of having that happen to you are considerably lower. But the third thing I wanted to say about this is that we do need to understand at the age of 84, and again, this is not just about Colin Powell, it's about anything. Something eventually is going to cause us to die. We are all going to die. You may have delusions that you're never going to die. You may be in your 20s and think, it's not happening to me. You may be one of these singularity people who thinks, no, we're going to cure death. Yeah. Into the foreseeable future, death is a thing. And it's not necessarily the enemy. At 84, with a cancer, something is going to be the tipping point. And those of us who work in internal medicine, who take care of a lot of elders, we see this, you know, whether it's pneumonia, whether it's, you know, an aspiration event where you get a pneumonia, whether it's a massive stroke, whether something is coming for us. And in the case of complex patients in complex situations who are much older, if you have a blood cancer and a virus infects you, a common cold could be the trigger that ends your life. It's something we just have to understand. So we do the best to mitigate risk, but you have to understand you never eliminate all risk. So that's how I think we should think about this situation. I hope this was helpful. If it wasn't, too bad. I love you guys so much. Please share the video, and we are out.